So what's up guys, Tech to Today, and here is the video you all have been waiting for, the Mifa Wildbox compared to the Trone Smart Bang. So both speakers are similar price. So the Mifa is still around 110, 130 euros, it really depends on when you buy it. And the Trone Smart was like one time even under 100, the Mifa was it in the beginning, but yeah, I kind of have the feeling that Mifa now knows that the parts of the speaker aren't cheap. Even JBL is using those midwoofers, for example. So with the Trone Smart, the normal price is very similar. I do have to say, even though the Trone Smart is a lot bigger, it isn't necessarily better in my opinion. But I will show you guys in the audio test, so you guys can see how it performs. So to be fair, the bass mode will be off, and also on the Trone Smart, no EQ will be used or whatsoever. So yeah, let's get right into it. So first play this song, and then we'll see how it performs. The Mifa will start. So I do have to say that the Trone Smart does have a little bit more volume, but yeah, I wouldn't say much better sound quality. The sound is great, especially with the vocal mode, you do get a little bit better clearness, and also the bass goes a little bit deeper. But with the Mifa, I already notice in real life, maybe on the microphone, yeah, it sounds a little bit different. But the bass is already a little bit deeper than on the Trone Smart. And the Trone Smart is bigger, and also somehow it is supposed to be a little bit more powerful. But even on the Mifa, I didn't use even the bass mode any at this moment. So, you know what, we will play the same song again, and we'll put the bass mode on, and to make it fair, the Trone Smart sound pulse mode. So in these modes, they both try to give the most power out of their speakers. So let's just continue the play with the Mifa. So definitely with the sound pulse mode, Trone Smart isn't really sounding like very great. So I really prefer to use the vocal EQ with the app of Trone Smart. But on the Mifa, the bass mode sounds very good. Very good bass and still not too much distortion. I had about an 8% volume. If you put the Mifa a little bit louder, so a 90 or 100% volume, the bass does increase a lot. So not like with JBL speakers that the bass like disappears. With Mifa, then the bass increase. Not like some other brands try to do with low volume. So again, the Trone Smart isn't bad. But yeah, it could be a little bit maybe better for the size. So yeah, I will play another song and then we'll see how that one performs. So I've put both speakers back on the normal settings again. And now we play a little bit different song. I will start with the Mifa and then we'll go of course to the Trone Smart. So this is a little bit different song and not like with that other song. Much deep bass tones in the beginning. Thank you. Chair. It isn't really easy to choose a winner. The Miva, I do have to say, it retails a little bit expensive because, yeah, it is a little bit more, yeah, build quality is a little bit better. With the Throne Smart, you do get a little bit more volume. So especially for outdoors, especially with the punchier bass in the little bit upper bass, you do get a little bit better audio profile for outdoors. But, yeah, Miva is still the winner for me. Especially because, yeah, I do think it's a little bit better in design. It's a little bit lighter, much easier to take with you. And the battery is also still enough for a half day. The Throne Smart, yeah, outdoors, Miva, indoors, and also outdoors if you need to go.